Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and I didn't want to make this video, but I kind of have to. It's been bred out of necessity, because there's some confusion going on as to what exactly is happening with the YouTube channel right now. And I wanted to make this video to clarify on a couple of things, as well as to enlighten people as to why you're not seeing as much YouTube content as I normally traditionally produce here on the channel. So the basics of it is that right now my channel is currently being inundated with these rights of commercialization flags. And what happens when you get these is that a video becomes demonetized. Regardless if it's a brand new video or an old video, sometimes the system's retroactive, sometimes it's very active and goes immediately. And right now, every single video that I currently upload to YouTube is being immediately flagged by this proof of commercialization. So this is what you see right here. And again, this is old videos. This is back from 2013. Some of these videos have been flagged like this, where it's not monetized. You need to provide proof of commercial rights, etc., etc. These are not, I repeat, these are not copyright flags. These are not copyright flags. In most cases, these are also not content ID flags. Now, what you see here with this match third-party content, this is from, again, over a year ago. These are more traditional flags. When people talk about their videos are getting flagged, matching third-party content like audio, visual, etc., that's what these are. And in this video in particular, the music that I used was copyrighted and it got flagged for that, which is the reason why it's no longer listed. I didn't want to take it down because of this demonstration. I want to show people exactly what the differences are. So this is a third-party content match. This is when a video or audio gets flagged by the automatic system built in by YouTube, matches something that the channel does not own. Now, in the case of the provide commercial rights flags here, in this case, the system has said, okay, well, we don't know if you have the rights to monetize this, so we need you to provide us with proof. Now, as proper as that may sound, legality-wise anyway, there is a huge issue with this, especially when you're talking about when it comes to income. During this time, whenever a video is flagged like this for non-monetized views, or if you need to provide proof of commercial rights, during this sort of limbo time, as I coined it, the content producer, the channel, does not generate any income at all, period. It doesn't matter how old the video is, it doesn't matter how far back it goes as far as views are concerned, that could have been monetized in the past. The problem is that any views that these videos tend to generate, regardless if there's ads on them or not, cannot be monetized. And if this video is indeed cleared by the system, let's say that I had Valve write me a proof of rights that I am allowed to use this and I submit that to YouTube, then that's fine. Then this video will be flagged for clear. It won't be flagged anymore. It'll be unflagged, clear for monetization. The problem is that the pay and the income that have already been lost in the limbo time are not recoverable. You cannot get any money back from any previously unmonetized views, and that's just how it works, and that's the biggest issue right now. To compound the issue that I'm also facing outside of the loss of income, mind you, it's not a lot of money, but hey, this is my only paycheck, so it's a lot of money to me. To compound the issue, the more videos that I release that get automatically flagged, the more that I'm going to be scrutinized, the more the channel is going to be scrutinized to get flagged even further, to the point where the channel will get eventually shut down. Not because I'm violating any copyright strikes, but because the automatic system that is built behind YouTube's infrastructure says this person keeps on trying to monetize stuff that we have no proof of. So the channel gets flagged as a troublemaker channel and eventually gets shut down. AdSense is broken. Your partnership with AdSense is ceased to exist. And that is a major problem, and I cannot allow that to happen right now. And let me go before I get to the recent stuff here. Let me just show you all the problem with this system that is in place. Again, this is YouTube. This is stuff I'm not making up. You may have seen similar videos by TB, by Angry Joe, in regards to content ID and copyright flags, that sort of thing. But what I'm talking about is slightly different when I'm talking about the rights of commercial rights, the commercial use rights of videos. These videos that you see here, these are old videos, sometimes going back to 2 years ago. these are videos that previously were monetized, that were retroactively demonetized. I've covered this in another video about a year and a half ago when the League of Legends stuff was happening, and it's cropped up again. And the reason why this is cropped up is because over the past week and a half, I did release a couple videos that were actively matched with third-party content. Now, those particular videos I disputed immediately because I've always had the rights to monetize that content, and for whatever reason there was a little bit of a lapse during the time that the dispute went through and the time that it was actually cleared. During that time I had two videos that were up generating views, generating income, that were under dispute, and I don't have any proof but I believe that because those two videos were under dispute but still actively getting hit every single day with thousands of views, they ended up causing this situation to where now I'm getting hit with these commercial rights flags again. And these are the most stubborn and the most irritating ones to get because of how slow Google is when it comes to responding to these issues. A couple people have said, Sinvicta, why don't you join an MCN? The answer is simply because I don't want to give up 30% of already what little money I have. Again, I cannot give, legally I cannot go into specifics on how much money I make each month from YouTube, but I can say it's under $400 right now. And giving up 30% of that is kind of like a big old FU to me, kind of, you know, yeah, if I join an MCN, it's going to take care of the problem, but then other problems become of that. Generally, my stance on it is I haven't needed an MCN this long. I want to keep 100% of my pie. I don't want to give it away for something that I've been getting for free, which is not having to worry about these commercial rights issues. So that's not an answer. That is not a solution to what the problem is right now. Going back to showing you how long this process is taking, and this is not anything that I've made up. If you want to go back, the best example as I can show is this Husky League video. This is the very first time that Husky and I recorded League over the course of a couple days. This video dates back to August 14th of 2013. That is over 2 years ago. I submitted a claim showing that, pointing them to the Riot video policy way back then, as soon as I got this retroactively demonetized. I sent in proof of commercial rights via the Riot video policy, and to this day it is still under review. Again, this is not manipulated footage in any way. This is recorded live. To this day, almost two and a half years later, we have a video that I submitted for commercial rights, having full legal rights and full proof to saying, yes, I've been able to monetize these videos in the past. This is the proof. It is still under review 2 years later. This is the problem that I'm having right now. So now, fast forward to today, to at the time of this recording, November 10th, 2015. I have actually uploaded the very first episode of the playthrough single player campaign for StarCraft II Legacy of the Void, the expansion that just came out today. This is currently under review. Now, monitoring for possible review does not mean under review. The difference between here and this one down here is the fact that YouTube has not received my request for review here. This one here, where it says under review, this is confirmation that YouTube has received my input and my proof of commercialization, and they're still reviewing it. Now, obviously, 2 years is a little extreme, but I'm just showing you this is a great example of what I'm talking about when we're talking about a lack of service from YouTube's side. And this is the most frustrating part. Right now, I have a video that I would totally love to release right now, but I cannot because it's under review. I could release it, but if I do that, releasing a video that is currently under review for monetization purposes causes your channel to create more scrutiny for the automatic system. This is all automated. I repeat, this is all automated. Earlier today, I looked at the Solo Queue Silliness that I released as of yesterday. This is going to be on the 9th of November. This video was not monetized and flagged for review. I sent in the commercial rights proof like I did for the other ones, like I did for these over here, like I did for this one earlier today. And it was cleared eventually by YouTube sometime in the afternoon. But The views that I generated from this video by the time from the time that I published it to whenever at whatever time it got released for monetization, those views and that income are completely gone permanently. I cannot gain any of that income back. And on top of that, the act of actually releasing a video that has been flagged for either possible review under the demonetization guidelines, flagged by the automatic system. Any video that I release and publish that are currently under review it basically makes the system look at the channel as a more of a problem channel, that saying, hey, this content creator continues to upload these videos that we don't have hard proof showing that this person has the right to commercially monetize all the assets contained in the video. Therefore, we cannot allow monetization. No matter if it's published or not, we cannot allow that. And let's see what other videos this person has tried to upload in the past or in the future. So now we're to a point now where I have a video that is ready to go. I'd love to release it on launch day for Legacy of the Void, that I cannot. I cannot do that. If I did, yes, I would be able to release it right now at the time of this video. Yes, it would start generating views, but no, I would not get any of that income. And going back to the old example, as to show you how flawed the system is and how bad the system is, in my opinion. And these sort of opinions are stuff that I tend to try to stay vanilla on, but this is important enough for me to give my personal opinion. This is a badly flawed system. This is a video from 2013 that is still under review. Yes, this video does not gain any hits anymore. Maybe one hit a month at this point because it's so old and I don't cover League anymore. But still, the principal point is that any views that this video currently gets, regardless of where it comes from, are basically getting thrown into the void. And any income that's generated from the ads that are placed on this video is also burned up into the oblivion. And I will never ever see that money. There's no back pay. There's no sort of prorated rate that content producers get if this sort of thing happens. It's just your SOL if your videos get flagged for demonetization and you're waiting for them to be under review. So there's a couple videos here as well that have been just flat out rejected. The We Love Bronze League Heroes video, which is a very short video that I released many, many, many years ago. It was originally monetized. Then it got flagged for commercial rights review. I sent in the commercial rights review and it was rejected by YouTube for whatever reason. And YouTube never ever gives you the reason why they will reject a video. But there's no sort of appeals process. It just flat out gets rejected. So any money that this video would have made is also gone. Now, a lot of people are going to say, well, Sinvicta, this is all about money. You're just trying to make sure you get the buck. And the answer is, yeah, it is about money. I'm trying to get paid for my work. This is my job. Asking me to work for free or asking me to give somebody 30% of my income to fix a problem that was never here before is not a solution. That is something that I will not allow. Right now, I cannot afford to be releasing new videos that are immediately getting demonetized and immediately getting flagged, because it puts my channel at a greater risk, and also it also jeopardizes my future in new media if I want to keep this part as a career. This is something I want to do. This is what I've dedicated my life to doing now at this point, and I will not allow anything to jeopardize that. So at the end of the day, I don't know how long this process is going to take. YouTube is notoriously terrible at responding to even partner channels. I'm not affiliated with any MCN. MCN, by the way, stands for multi-channel network. So like Polaris, like Freedom Network, like Broadband, whatever, like Curse, you know, that sort of thing. I'm not affiliated with any of that. I have a direct partnership with Google through AdSense, meaning that I get to keep everything that I get instead of splitting it off into payments and memberships for MCNs that I currently don't need and haven't needed yet. I've tried to contact YouTube. We hear nothing back. It's nothing out of the ordinary to not hear anything from YouTube. Again, going back to my other example here, we have a 2-year-old video that's still under review. I rest my case. So bottom line, I have no idea when we can expect this rough patch to stop. I honestly wouldn't be surprised if this video is flagged. And yeah, I'm going to release this video regardless if it's flagged or not, because everyone needs to get an update on A, what's going on, and B, a great example of showing how incredibly flawed and incredibly broken the automatic flagging system is for YouTube. There's no reason why I should have to provide proof of commercialization on videos that I've been monetizing for sometimes years. I had a Binding of Isaac episode that was exported from Twitch. It was recorded about a week ago at the time of this recording. And that set off the chain of reactions of showing like, hey, you need to provide commercialization. Hey, we need proof. YouTube needs proof, blah, blah, blah. That is not related to Blizzard. I've had Blizzard videos that have been under the same fire, non-Blizzard videos alike as well, and brand new videos, old videos, etc. The problem is so complex with a system that is almost unworkable. You really cannot depend on this automatic flag system. And coupled with the fact that there's really no one at YouTube that you can reach out and discuss these problems with, adds to the frustration level. So there's nothing really that I can do other than just wait. I'm waiting to hear back from YouTube. For some odd reason, this has started cropping up again. I do believe that this is the product of the two public now cleared videos that were originally under dispute. I do believe that this is a product of that. The fact that I did release two videos that were under review for dispute, but they were later cleared. But now I'm still dealing with the fallout of worrying about, well, is this video going to get flagged or not? Am I going to be able to upload this without it getting flagged? Is my channel going to get shut down? These are all very, very real issues. So I don't know how long it's going to take. I would love to say it's fixed tomorrow. I would love to say it's fixed tonight. I honestly don't know. For those of you who are fans of my Twitch channel, Twitch TV is not going to be affected whatsoever. In fact, I may start streaming more if I cannot rely on the YouTube income, which, as I've already stated, is not a lot of money. But hey, when you're talking about not a lot of money and you don't get any money for it, then you're talking about a lot of problems and a big deal. It doesn't matter how much money I'm going to be getting or not getting from these videos. The bottom line is that it threatens the channel, and I cannot allow that to happen. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them in the comments. I'll be more than happy to answer them. You can also email me privately if you have issues or if you have some insight on the problems that I'm currently facing but do not want to do it publicly. You can email me at sinvicta316@gmail.com. I'll be more than happy to take up inquiries there. So thank you very much, everyone. I do appreciate the concern. I hope that this video brings a little bit of light. And again, I'll be more than happy to answer any questions that you may have regarding this issue, and I'll try to address them as soon as possible. Hopefully, we can see the return of content soon. I would have loved to put episode 1 of the StarCraft Legacy of the Void campaign up tonight. Obviously, I can't do that for the aforementioned reasons, and I'll release it as soon as I can. So again, thank you very much for watching, everyone. I hope you continue to support the channel. I truly appreciate it, especially during these kind of rough patches here, and I can't wait to resume giving you all more entertainment in the mosh pit. So until next time, everyone, this is Sinvicta, and I'll see you later.